Hey guys, I'm Gabbers, and this week I'm gonna be talking to you guys about boobs. So I am going to try and record this video without glasses because I got a new video light and it leaves a pretty big glare. So we're gonna see how long I can last with that. But this week I'm gonna be talking to you guys about breast augmentation, but I won't be talking about breast implants. I'm actually going to be talking about fat transfer, which is something I've been looking into a lot for myself. So first I'm going to go into some of the notes that I wrote down and some of the things that I found out that I thought was interesting. So what fat transfer is pretty much what they do is they perform liposuction on a part of your body that you have fat to spare. Normally they would take it from your stomach or your thighs or your butt or like your love handles, any area that you have fat to spare, they can take it from there. It can be performed on thin girls or skinnier girls. They just kind of have to pull fat from wherever they can get it from. So they perform the liposuction, and then the fat is harvested through liposuction, and then it is then made into smaller bits of fat, so it's a little easier to inject. And then when it's made smaller, they remove the dead cells from it, and so that they give you all the live cells and they implant it into you. And the reason they remove the fat or the dead fat cells is because it gives you a higher chance of a survival, because sometimes your body will absorb it right away and then you've pretty much lost what you spent your money on. A couple pros of it is that it's inserted through very small incisions on multiple parts, multiple locations on your body, so that there's no like long scar or anything like that like you would get with an implant. Though some of the breast implant women that I've seen, it gets pretty light over time. Another pro is that it is not a foreign object. It is from your body, it is your fat, so there won't be any reaction like with an implant, be it saline or silicone. With those, your body has a chance of reacting to it and you would have to get it taken out. But with fat cells and the fat transfer, it's your own body. So what it does is it just, the only thing that can happen is that it can absorb back in, because fat absorbs sometimes. But yeah, so that's why like one of the pros is that it's relatively permanent, because I mean it's more permanent than a breast implant, because a breast implant on one side you have to get it changed throughout the years because of multiple things. So with fat transfer, it goes in, it doesn't come out unless you lose weight. Another pro is that you get liposuction, which it helps with body shaping, and I mean you lose weight through that and whatnot, so I mean it gets your body a little smaller and slimmer and all that jazz. And then because it is your own fat, it's your own tissue, it's gonna feel natural and it's gonna look like a real boob rather than, I mean my personal opinion, most breast implants look like a circle on your chest and it doesn't look like a real boob. The cons that I kind of found is that it can absorb, the fat can absorb back into your body. So if you were to work out a lot and lose a lot of weight, there is a chance that it could absorb back in and it wouldn't be as prominent anymore. Their other con is that you can't go drastically bigger. So you can go about a half a cup to a cup, to one full cup size bigger each time you go in for fat transfer. So if you wanted to go drastic sizes, that's when they would suggest that you go with an implant. Another con is it's more expensive. The reason it's more expensive is because they have to harvest the fat cells a different way, and it's a different procedure, and it's liposuction and breasts. So it's a little more costly than implants, but I feel like the pros outweigh the cons on this part. The whole reason that I was looking into this and I thought about talking about it was because it is something I'm looking into and I'm considering. Having my daughter really drastically deflated my boobs pretty much. The fat transfer is something I'm looking into, along with the tummy tuck. Granted, I do not have the money for this anytime soon, so this is just a thought process that I'm researching and kind of preparing myself for if it is something that I'm really I really want to do. So like the main reason I wanted to go with fat transfer over like an implant is because when it came to my like loss of volume and whatnot, it's because, well, one, when I went in to give birth to my daughter, I weighed 275 pounds. Currently, I weigh 185 pounds. So, since the birth of my daughter, I have lost 90 pounds. That's a lot of weight to lose, along with having a child. And with having a child, boobs get really big. And I did not breastfeed, but I pumped for the first month, so my boobs, they'd get enlarged and engorged, and I was at a triple E, I think, or an F when they would get full, and now I'm just a 38 double D on a good day, I guess you could say. So it's something I've looked into because I don't want to go like this drastic big size, but I have always wanted bigger boobs. And now, because of a child that I love oh so much, my body is 100% different than it ever was before her. So now I'm considering things that I never really considered beforehand, like plastic surgery. But yeah, I think I'm just kind of rambling on at this point. I hope you guys liked the better lighting, I guess. I don't know, the shadow's kind of weird. Next week I might record with my new camera because I got like a vlog camera pretty much. And yeah, I'm excited because it has better autofocus than my DSLR. So I'm excited to try this out and have you guys tell me what the quality looks like on next week's video. I do want to apologize for not making a video last week, though I probably don't need to. With it being Christmas and my daughter's birthday, it was pretty hectic. I also went out of town a couple days ago and just got back in. So these past 2 weeks have been, or this past week has been pretty hectic for me. So I hope at least that you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to comment down below if you have any questions or concerns. Leave a like if you like this video and subscribe so you don't miss a video from us. And on that note, I'll see you guys next week. Bye guys!